Okay, now let's check our article controller. What we will do is whatever we have in the auth controller, we can simply copy paste that and we will change the routes in the article controller. So article means create article, update article, delete article, fetch articles by the user. All these routes I do see, and we are going to have article service. So I will create a service also. And article service will look somewhat similar to the auth service. I mean, it will be dealing with a different stuff, like the, it will be just dealing with the articles instead of prisma.user. It will be using the prisma.article. Okay, so in the article service, we can talk about, okay, get article, create article, all these different set of APIs. So first of all is article, let's say the create article. And it will have some input like article and the username. And it is going to have a username which is of type string. Article is of type any. Okay, let's empty the body. Here we are going to create a new article. Okay, similarly, that will be update, delete, add comments and all these APIs we are going to expose from this. So create article, let's say in the article, in the request body, we are getting all these attributes. Attributes are known as, let's say, the title of the article, description, body, tag list, all these things we are getting from article, and it's type any, so it will allow us. Now we can actually add a JOI validation. Okay, that this all the required attributes are being passed or not, that we can do. And then I will be using so we are getting the username which is unique throughout the table, so we can call another method, find user by username, and just pass the username, because we need to know who is the user, what is the user who is creating the article, right? So what we can do is in the auth service, auth controller, auth service, we can use either the existing method if we have, or we can create a new method. What will be the name of the method is find user ID by username. Okay, it is taking user ID, prisma.user find unique, and here where user name, here we just need to select the ID. ID is true, and here we can just check. If we got the user, that means everything is good. Otherwise, if we didn't get the user, then things are not good. We can throw HTTP exception. 404 user not found, an empty object or whatever. So just import the HTTP exception. I think we have created this class in the utils. If everything is good, we have the user object, return that. So find this we are getting from the service. Now go to the article service and just import this from the auth service. Yes, so now we got the user object. Now what we are going to do, we know who is the logged in user. Let's allow this user to create the article. And if you have seen the article websites, we always create a slug. And we use sluggy file. I think there is already a library we have imported. That sluggy file based on the title and based on the user ID. Sluggy file, we have the title and we already have the user ID. User will always be there. Sluggify user ID. Okay, so this is the slug name. Now we can see that in the article, the slug name is unique. I mean, when you are writing article, you cannot have a two same name of the article, right? So what we do is, we'll just try to identify, do we have existing article? existing article equal to await, then same Prisma dot article dot find unique, and inside find unique you will pass the object like where close. We already have a slug, so just pass the slug. And in where close you need to specify what you are trying to select. So select slug from article table where slug equal to this, right? So either it will be undefined or either it will be some existing slug if you already have. So it is existing article. So what we will do is we will just check if this existing article is there. If we found this existing article, that means we already have the article, you can go back, right? So what we can just do is throw new HTTP exception. It should be unprocessable entity. Okay, you can customize this. Errors, title, and you can just pass anything. Must be unique. And just get the HTTP exception. Just a typo. Now we can just call the create method, because now we have everything ready. We have done the checks, we have the user ID and all. So const article equal to await Prisma dot article dot create. Now you need to see that article has a lot of association with the other data, and we are going to pass a lot of data inside it. So data can be okay, the title is one, slug is another attribute, then we have body and description, and then the tag list. Now here is the important part. So tag is already an entity. First of all, it is complaining title article create input. Let's call it as a created article. Because there is a variable name conflict. And this is the data. Now it is requiring, okay, you need to pass the author, that is required. These are the required things you need to pass. That's why obviously the property author is missing. So first of all, the tag list. Okay, so now here there is a catch. Here tags are the independent entity. Tags are a separate model. If you just see the Prisma schema which we have created, tags were considered as a separate identity table. And if we even see the Postgres table, okay, that's not there. Tags has a relationship with the articles. Okay, here you can see the tags and there is an article to the tag. It's like many to many relationship. So what we need to do is, let's say I already have created 10 different tags. Now I wanted to associate those tags with article. So Prisma provides this utility, connect or create. Let's use that. So tag list, we are getting this as a array of these tags which we are getting from the body. These are array of strings. Okay, so what we can do here is tag list dot map. List dot map, and here we are getting each and every tag as a string. And here we can, so what is this? This is the tag list, and inside that we have to create an object. Sorry for that. And inside this we can use connect or create. Yeah, this is autocomplete. That means either we can connect the existing tags which are already created in the tag entity, or we can create the new one, right? So here we can create tag list dot map each and every tag of type string. So in this we have to pass, this is actually a JSON object, it is going to return. Here we can do two things, either we can create or connect the existing tag. So name equal to tag and the where clause. I mean, I initially like this approach where you can actually either create the new one or connect the existing one. Similarly, we are going to connect with the author. So we have another important property is author, right? And here, because author is already created, we are just going to use connect. So there, these are the two important utilities I see in the Prisma, connect or create. So connect with the author, where the ID is user.id. So I have to do nothing. If I wanted to populate the author ID or author relationship or the tag relationship with the article, this is how I'm doing it. So this is our data, and inside this, we can just specify what all things you wanted to include. Okay, once the insertion is done, right? So inside include, I wanted to get the tag list, and inside tag list, I wanted to select the name only true. This I initially didn't like, because you have to create a kind of hierarchy. Once the insertion is done, I wanted to include these things inside a response. From the tag list, I wanted to select the name, and then from author. But these autocompletes helps. Inside author, I wanted to select a username. So that will be true. Bio of that user who is writing this, and the image, if we have it, that is true. This is all your query. So where it is opening and where it is closing, that we have to see. These are the includes, and this is the closing of the query. So after that, I mean, it is going to return the created article. I will not play with this thing, and I will just return the created article. Otherwise, you can actually see what all attributes you wanted to return from this. Are we doing opening closing correctly? Okay, so this is create article. Now same way we can actually do get particular article, like currently we are not, this is the article creation, we haven't added comments and all these things, but like once the user will see the article, he will be able to add a comments and all these things. So get article is another interesting method. Rest all is like plug this in with the some controller method. So we have get article. Sorry, this method is get one article, and here you have to specify what is unique. Slug is unique, and the username, right? Because slug, you are going to get the article by the slug name. Okay, I will just clean the body from inside this method, so we can rewrite this. I was thinking to reuse some pieces from here. Get one article. Okay, so what we are going to do is, I have the username. Okay, so here it is going to be the simple query, const article equal to await prisma dot article dot find unique, because there will be only one entry with this slug. And here we will specify the where clause, and here we will just specify, okay, based on this slug, give me the article. Why it is complaining? Find unique where sometimes, okay, it was just a TypeScript thing. And once we are done with this where clause, we need to include some data in the response. Okay, so I'm saying, okay, give me the tag list. and I'm just selecting name of the tag is true. Okay, this is tag list, first inclusion, and then we have author. From the author, select username. Username true. If you need some more attributes, you can just set them. It's kind of a GraphQL stuff, right? Feel like, not the exact GraphQL. Okay, you can select whatever you want. And then, because further you will also add comments. So here you can select particular things about the comment. It's comments. Okay, inside this, what you are selecting is the ID, the comment ID. So you will set true for that. And then let's say the body of the comment, whatever the comment user has added, and inside that comment, you also have author, and you can see this automatically populating. This is the beauty of it. That's why you don't need to confuse, okay, comments has the author, because comment will be created by some author. And then you can again do the select, which I really don't like much, because here every time you have to select, okay, from this inner join, from the comments, if you wanted to populate user, then what all attributes you wanted to specify. You can just copy and paste username, comments, and bio. So these are a couple of attributes we have. There are a couple of more, but let's keep it simple for now. So these are the includes. This is the where clause, and we can just return this article. You can do the transformation and all. So this is get one article. We don't need to identify, okay, find one user, because we are doing where clause. We are not doing, okay, give me the article where the slug is this and the user ID is this. No. So this is optional. Inside this payload, you can specify, okay, this author is this and all these things. So get one article, create an article. And let's test these methods. Okay, so let's do the testing of article controller. We have created two APIs, create article and get one article by slug, right? This is just, I integrated that services with the controller, and this is our Prisma routes just for the demo purpose. Here I have article controller, and this is our article controller post articles and get article by slug. So while creating article, we are creating some dynamic slug, and that using that slug as a query parameter, you can get that slug. This it is calling the same method get one article, which we have written in the same video, get one article and create one article. Okay. So let's see the demo. What we need is our, we already are a logged in user. We did sign up. We got the token, right? And we are going to use the same token here, because these both the APIs are protected. Oh, what I mean to say that is, in the articles you can see auth.required. It is using Express JWTV. I mean, that middleware that will just decode the token and will extract the username for us. We need this while creating the article, not while fetching the article. So here we can just test this. Let's say I want to do the create article. Let's say I'm just doing a POC Node.js. And here I'm just putting a tags for my blog is Prisma. Prisma is awesome. I'm just exploring and sharing. Right? So this is the article I'm creating. I'm already logged in user, so I'm passing the token, and let's create it. So it will create this slug, and using this slug, I can get this article again. Okay, you can see it has the author populated, it has the tag list. We will also check the database, what the database contains. We can use this thing while fetching the article. And here you can see this is the query parameter, and I will just do get, and here we are. I can see what I needed. Like the author information is populated. If we have the comments added on this article, then we would have populated that also, the tag list, author ID and all. Now let's take a look on to the database. What do I have here? Here you can see I couple of populated the blog post, even the tags are also there. The users, we have two users, and you can see some kind of relationships here. Many to many user follows we don't have, but the articles to the tag, right? The articles, these are the five articles and the tags. These four articles have the same tag. The fifth article has the Prisma as a tag. So it's like a many to many relationship table between the articles and the tags. But we don't need to worry about it because we are not even doing any read write operation in this particular table. Prisma internally managing all those things for us. We can see that these are the two tags we have created and these are the two users. Okay, so this is all about the article controller. We might add some more controller routes for the comments, for the tags, but this is the kind of POC I wanted to show with the Prisma, how this connect and create really works and makes our task very easy. Like in the article services we have done at many places, like data, here we are doing connect or create, here we are doing connect because we already know the user already exists, and here we can populate the relationships. We are fetching the article, but I can fetch the tags, I can fetch the author, I can fetch the comments by writing these kind of things because we already defined the relationship in the schema models. Okay, that's it guys. Thanks everyone. This is the part 4 of this. Now in the coming up videos I will cover the nestjs with the Prisma, and then we will close up the Prisma things and we will build the full stack clone apps which I have already populated on my channel.